In this video, I would like to talk with you about the magic and mystery of games. This working with games is something which I've seen done in many traditions. It used to be quite normal in the Middle East. It used to be very normal also in Asia, in Eastern Europe, and unfortunately, this tradition has kind of been lost in Western Europe, and now also in Middle East and North Africa. This tradition has disappeared, unfortunately. But in large parts of Asia and Eastern Europe, this tradition is still very much alive. The idea is very simple behind it. It is basically that powers exist without form. And if you make a form available to them, then they can manifest themselves, then they can show themselves. So anything can be in a way possessed by a higher power, become a symbol, a representation of such a higher power. So that higher power can be observed, which otherwise would be invisible. So this is very much the mystery of games, where you learn to recognize which higher powers are manifesting in which situation. So it's a game is in a way like going to a theater play or watching a movie, where a person is in a way playing the role of the villain or the role of the hero, or representing some power or authority, while they're not actually that at all. So if I'm playing chess or playing cards, yes, it is a piece of metal, a piece of wood, a piece of cardboard, a piece of paper, some paint. But at the same time, it is also this higher power displaying the role of. So you could say every game is like a theater play for the powers which are represented in it. And not every game is, of course, such a mystery game. These powers will have to be welcomed. They cannot take possession of our world unless we grant them the right. Like, this is my chess piece, or this is my card deck, or this is my backgammon board, and I have authority of it, being its owner in this physical sense. And I can say, okay, I invite these powers to come into my cards, into my chess, or into my backgammon, or even into my computer game. Take possession of the forms which are available in this world. And in a computer game, these are virtual forms. But it is still very possible for a power to take command of them, and to manifest its energies through them. And after such an invitation has been accepted, and also a focus has been made, it is not just opening it up to the universe, because that would be far too complex for a game to manifest. So a game is like a model. It's a very simplified version of something. So you could say, like, okay, in this game I'm going to model my relationship with my dog, or my relationship with my colleagues, or with my boss, or with a certain spiritual power. And if it's a very limited thing, you can usually see, okay, what are my allies, what are my opponents, and what are my obstacles, what are my weaknesses, how am I. You can try also, okay, if I act in a certain way, use a certain tactic or strategy, does this work or doesn't it work? In this way, you can also, you could say, experiment a little bit in your model to prepare yourself for acting in the real world. In such a game, it is important also not to try to force things. The game is not played to win or to achieve the goals within the game. you're more of an observer within the game and of course a participant. But the other powers are not there to become your slaves. And in a way they're not your slaves, but they can be of course worked with, they can be manipulated. Because whatever you do in a symbolical fashion is also a symbol or a request to the essence of the power, like could you support me, or could you move out of the way, or could you take this obstacle into a different place or bring it closer, because I now have the energy to deal with it, but may not later. So these manipulations are also a language. The game is a communication you're having with all these powers, with all these participants. This way of working has been in a way banned in many Christian and Islamic cultures because of its power, because of its, you could say, challenge to the supreme control by God. Many more fundamentalist Muslims and Christians believe that there is only one power which rules everything, and that is the will of God. And that having our own will, having our own control, is in a way blasphemy, that you're denying the will of God. And they are right. We are also, even though we try our utmost to follow the will of God, most of us are still denying the will of God simply because we cannot fathom the will of God. We cannot listen. And we're all so impure. That even though if we could listen, there are still these lower desires, these lower impulses, these obfuscations, these misinterpretations, these illusions, which prevent me from being a perfect tool to the Supreme Creator. So I think we have to accept that we are not following the will of God. We also have to accept that there is an own will, which is trying to manifest itself, and that working with games, working with magic, working with symbolism is a method for this smaller will or this imperfect will to develop itself. And this development can be towards God, but I would have to admit that mainly this working with games have been used towards lower purposes, towards dealing with one's enemies, here on a more physical level, or gaining certain power, certain qualities, also to serve the ego rather than to serve the divine will. So there is a lot of opportunity for misuse of the power of games, but there is also a great blessing within the power of games. Because you can also work with very spiritual motives, like how can I grow spiritually, how can I improve the quality of my love to become more as a divine love, how can I help my fellow beings which are trapped also in this state of impurity and ignorance, what can I do to overcome my also spiritual obstacles, not just physical ones. So I think it is wrong to in a way cast out the magic of games and divination altogether, but rather we should learn how to use this in a way which is beneficial to us and which does not mislead us and only serve our egos, which ultimately, even though they are followed, can never be satisfied and will die together with the body, no matter what we do. So we are wasting our life, our time, our energy with trying to fulfill an impossible goal of satisfying the ego, and all the benefits we generate for the ego are ultimately lost at the end of our lives. So with this awareness, we can use games and we can use the magic and mystery of the game. Very positive way.